The Art of Non-Duality. I keep coming back to this non-duality concept because it is so much at the crux of creation, and indeed why we as infinite creators continually choose to participate in such an extreme form of duality. It is a dramatic world of opposites, contrasts, and all the messy gray areas in between. Don't we have something better to do than just get all tangled up in this morass? Well, no. You see, by experiencing and being these extreme states of opposites, we come to know ourselves as infinite beings. By the sheer contrast of the non-being and solidness represented by life here in Planet Rock, it reveals to us our infiniteness. Most of what we experience is what we are subconsciously co-creating with all these other infinite creators. It doesn't seem like we're creating the universe of our lives because most of what is being created is what we subconsciously agreed to be a part of coming into this life. As we, quote, wake up, end quote, or become aware of this fact, we can then start making conscious choices about what we prefer to experience. What it takes to wake us up, though, is usually a carnival ride of torturous swings from one extreme to the other. We're seemingly tossed back and forth from dark to light, hard to soft, easy to difficult, and everything in between. The bewildering input of contrasts assaulting our senses seems to be more of an attack against us, throwing us into defense mode. Is it any wonder that most of us just put our heads down and take the path of least resistance, complying and compromising our own preferences in the hope of getting by, fitting in, and for God's sakes, not rocking the boat? It just seems easier, or at least a whole lot less threatening, to find some comfortable niche, dig in, hoping to avoid any real revelation of the infiniteness of who we are and the crushing responsibility of our own creations. With the advent of the planetary information web, the internet, and the inevitable development and involvement in social media, or what I call selective hive minds, we can compartment and validate our own value systems, creating our own self-bubbles that shut out dissenting views or emotional conflict. This serves to amplify our responses when we stick our heads up every once in a while and are bombarded by the seeming insanity of an opposite world assaulting us. We either quickly duck back into our comfort zones or take up arms to attack those opposing our niches we've become so attached to, mostly in self-defense. There eventually arises a desire to rise above it all, to transcend the hive minds and get beyond all the conflict of this opposite world. This is nature's way of squeezing our consciousness into present time awareness and drives us to be mindful and non-judgmental about everything around us. It's the only way out, really, and even though it's difficult, it's certainly preferable to living in a hole in defense mode. Our lives then become a series of self-awarenesses about our automatic responses developed in self-defense against assaults on our personal values and ego attachments. The door is opened, and now we cannot go back. What is seen cannot be unseen, and leads to more awareness and more clarity. At some point, there is a reckoning, and in a slow flash, we start to see this conflicted world as the birthing of something greater, something inherently beautiful in its becoming, a world where polarities merge into a continuum of necessities, much like the birthing process where writhings of pain morph into the beauty of a new life. It all needs to be there. It's all happening because it's supposed to happen. All the suffering, pain, agony, joy, glory, and poignancy coalesces into one immense, amazing, and glorious birthing event. There are no longer opposites, but spectrums of being, none better or worse or righter or more wrong than the other. Without the one, there cannot be the other, and both are required for what is being wondrously created. It becomes a matter of dropping all our requirements of what should be, uncreating all the evaluations, judgments, and conclusions about what we see and experience out there, and by doing so, out there becomes in here, And at last, we have a shot at truly creating the glorious world we've always known is possible.
You have been listening to This Quantum Life by Boyd Martin, brought to you by the Quantum Health Newsletter from Pure Energy RX, www.pureenergyrx.com.